We often face a feeling of otherness in the workplace, a feeling of otherness in the community, a feeling of trying our best to put a tough skin on, a tough outer skin on the things and the turmoils that we deal with. We all have to deal with explaining discrimination to our kids and why it happens, and trying at least to justify why that happens, but even not really understanding it ourselves.
I have so many experiences that I can draw from. I recall that I was communicating with the company that we were going to do business with for months, and our communication was cordial. We had no issues throughout. And there was a time when we had to have a face-to-face meeting. And when I turned up, the boss in charge said out loud, "Oh, this company is owned by a Black person?" And it took me off guard.
Workplace discrimination and being paid less, not necessarily being looked at the same with somebody as somebody who has the same experiences as you do, someone who might have less experience getting promoted over you because of the color of their skin.
Probably like 5 years into, you know, having some success with music, I was driving a Mercedes at the time, and I was pulled over by a cop. And the first thing he asked me is, "Whose car is this?" And I'm like, "That's my car." We went all the way to trial, and I didn't get charged for speeding. The judge thought I wasn't going fast enough. He had nothing to prove it. But that same cop harassed me for 3 years until we went into trial. He was very disrespectful to me. He removed me and my 12-year-old brother out of the car in the middle of the highway. We had to like stand there while my car got towed.
Just the day-to-day fears of dealing with the police when you get stopped, and feeling that sense of nervousness in the pit of your stomach of wondering if you're going to do everything properly or how that encounter is going to end.
It's ridiculous, man. There's so many stories I could sit here and tell you all day, you know?
I think these are things that I share with a lot of people that I would like to try to help change and to help educate people about. That I think the opportunity now with the subcommittee and task force gives me an opportunity to take a stand in that and to be able to help in that, helping to change that. Can't change it overnight, but at least starting to.
It's extremely important that the city of Pickering take action, and that the fact that we're leaders is gratifying, but it's really not the intent. The intent is to take meaningful action, to deal with racism within our community, and by dealing with it in our community, affecting the broader community, the world as a whole.
The approach includes forming a Pickering Anti-Black Racism Task Force. Out of that task force is going to come anti-Black racism action plans that will be executed. But on a bigger level, there is also developing a diversity and inclusion strategy, a 10-year strategy to address all kinds of racism and discrimination issues in the city of Pickering.
The city of Pickering represents the leadership of Pickering. People look to their leaders for accountability. They look to their leaders to set the tone. So the city of Pickering and its leadership should be that lighthouse. We should be the ones blazing the trail. And we are such a diverse city. If we do not accept the charge to make change in the area of anti-Black racism, we would be falling behind. We would be neglecting a significant part of our population. And I think that the old adage says that if one is not free, then we're all not free, then that has to be applicable here. There's a legal adage that says silence speaks consent. That's exactly what we'll be doing. Our silence or inaction will be just that.
It's important to me to be an advocate because I think, why not me? You know, I want my children, I want other people and other Black people in Pickering as well to feel like they can have a voice and they can make a difference as well. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's important that if you have something to contribute in any small way, shape, or form that's going to help educate people and prevent people from experiencing racism, that's going to help people who think that they're not racist understand that maybe they are doing things that are racist, change what they're doing, and be better educated about different cultures, and helping people to understand that underneath the skin, we're all human. We all have the same pains. We all want our kids to grow up.
my thing is I want to come in here and show people that there is a way, you know, there is people you can reach out to. You know, unfortunately, there's a lot of people with messed up family situations. There's no guidance for young black men. And sometimes they just get lost in the sauce and they have no direction or no motivation, no, you know, mentorship, nobody to really push them in the right direction. So
in relation to developing the diversity and inclusion strategy is one that we have established a citywide staff diversity and inclusion working group that comes from across the organization, all levels and all different areas of the organization. And then also we have we've completed an RFP, a request for proposal, that will result in the hiring of a consultant in 2021 to be able to help facilitate the completion of the diversity and inclusion strategy.
It's important that this is community driven because we have to get the feeling from the community. I mean, if we had done it right, if we knew what was wrong and addressed it, we would have done so. We need the community to share with us their experiences, their feelings, and help us to address the systemic basis for those feelings and for the unfortunate incidences that have occurred.
If I were to group the things that I would like to see accomplished in two big brackets, I would say empowerment of the Black community in one bracket and advocating for concrete change in another bracket. And when I say empowering the Black community, I mean that many Black people in general do not feel empowered. And I refer to a phrase that we often attribute to Bob Marley, but actually came from Marcus Garvey, which is we have to emancipate ourselves from mental slavery. We allow the strangleholds or the hindrances that have placed in society to be so internalized that we don't push ourselves. We don't advocate for ourselves. We only try to get to this far and not further. We can do exploits and we need to push against those barriers, break those barriers with conversation, with advocacy, with policy change. I want to advocate for policy change. We've seen tons of reports. We've seen tons of meetings with very little concrete change. I favor the small steps we've made, but we need to go beyond that to have curriculum change.
As we have identified the fact that there is systemic racism, as we have admitted that there is systemic racism, the City of Pickering Council felt it was important to take real and specific and tangible action. And but so what we have done is we have created the Anti-Black Racism Task Force that is community-driven. We are having people from the community come and engage with us directly to share their experiences, to tell us exactly what they see happening, and so that we can together engage in those difficult situations that will help us to address the feelings, address the specific problems, and to make the necessary corrections.
The diversity and inclusion strategy will assist employees by bringing out recommendations that the city as an employer needs to understand and take action on in order to be able to make working at the city feel more welcome and inclusive. And we need to feel that if city employees feel that they are included and they feel like they belong, they'll be able to in turn provide inclusive services to our diverse community.
We want the very diversity that we have to be safe for everyone. And it can't be safe for everyone if any one group is not safe.
These are things that we all want, but we don't all get. And I think if we're willing to face anti-racism and racism and fight for anti-racism, then we'll have a better chance of living in a Pickering that everyone can feel safe and included in.
We've engaged in many conversations over the last weeks and months to try and elicit that information, and we'll continue to do so. And those conversations often are very, very difficult because it forces us to confront those real issues of racism, of privilege, and of the systemic base for the problem that obviously exists within our community. And it's through those conversations that we are going to address them. But I think it's important for all of us to recognize that this isn't something that is going to change overnight. It's not something that can change overnight. But we can, beginning today and going forward, make an honest effort and be honest with ourselves about what the problems are and our role in that problem as we move forward together.
Me coming into this, what I want to do is show people that there's a way, there's people that you can reach out to, there's ways of going about things, and there's hope, you know? And I just want to be a person or one of the people that help guide them in the right direction.